Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and welcome to part two of our attempt to rebuild sort of the feels and the scenes of the Lost World Jurassic Park right here in Jurassic World Evolution. Now, in the first episode, we built ourselves our lovely little Stegosaurus enclosure. I'm actually going to go ahead and shrink this right now because it is far too unnecessarily large. They really only need to be in this little bit at the bottom, so grab that there, and we'll cut all that off. But the next scene we're going to do is the game trail. I think we might actually put it right here. Now, the game trail scene... Oh, no, I want to leave that there. The game trail scene, of course, is where the gang, as they shall now be called, Eddie and Owen and so forth. Not Owen, what am I on about? Vince Vaughn's... Oh, Vince Vaughn's character was called Owen, right? I'm not crazy. Eddie and Malcolm and the lot, they all head over to the game trail and they watch the bad men... The second team, the sort of renegade team-ish from InGen, capture all the dinosaurs and stuff like that on this long game trail savanna sort of thing. Now, it's going to be quite difficult to do that. There's something I want to try super quickly. I'm not convinced it's going to work, but I do want to give this a go. If I go into guests, going to enclosures. I want to stick down a monorail, gyro station, I should say. And... I just want to try this out, right? So that, see, if that color there is really good for a game trail, right? That looks way more like the game trail than the default grass. So I'm just wondering, I might be optimistic on my... Why is that straight? I mean, you could put a few of these in. What I'm thinking is I could have just two of these maybe? I don't know. I think it'll look really cool if I can sort of hide these gyrospheres. Is that crazy? It kind of makes it look more like a trail, right? It does have lights on it, which is a bit of a shame. It kind of looks more like an airstrip, but I think it might be a good idea. I'm going to move them back a little bit. I think we're going to go for it. I'm going to try to stick them a little bit closer together, but we're just going to have this kind of two strips down the middle, just to make it feel a little bit different. It might be awful, we might get rid of it, but yeah, I'm going to do it for now. Fortunately, the game trail is absolutely surrounded by massive forest, which is really helpful for us. The first thing we need, however, is Mementisaurus. Let's get some dinosaurs on the way. So, on the game trail, there's Mementisaurus, Parasaurolophus, Pachycephalosaurus, and Gallimimus. Now, there is also Compsognathus and T-Rex that do appear, not on the game trail necessarily, but the T-Rex is in the area because it eats from the game trail. They actually mentioned that in the film. And, of course, we do see the Compi. I'm not going to include either of those just because the Compi's, well, not in the game. And the T-Rex isn't actually seen sort of there as part of that scene, which is kind of what I'm going for. I believe there's only one Mementi. I could be incorrect on that. I'm not 100% sure. That's what I'm going with. I'm going with one. And I think I'm going to go for the default Parasaur as well. How many Parasaurs do I want? I'm thinking like 6 Gallimimuses, 4 Pachycephalosauruses, 2 Parasaurolophuses. You reckon that's a good mix? I don't think... I don't know. I'm thinking about it. We'll see what happens. Let's just let the Mementi... I kind of want to bring out all the dinosaurs. No. Okay, let's get the Gallimimus. Let's start the Gallimimuses. There we go. I've made the decision. And I think we're going to stick with the default colouring. For now. They've got that kind of brown savanna kind of look to them, you know? So. Let's grab ourselves a gyrosphere. Now, I need to figure this out exactly. Which side is it? Right, okay, good. Got that in the bag. I do want this to be pretty long. You reckon that's enough? I mean, the tree line is going to come up quite a bit because I want to completely cover the gyrosphere station, of course, so you can't see it, so you just see, like, this. I'm not sure if that doesn't look stupid or not. It'll be easy to get rid of if it looks stupid, so you guys can let me know what you think before the next episode, and I can get rid of it if need be. I actually want that to be this way, I think. I think it's okay. From above, from sort of this height, you don't really see the lights. It looks like... maybe it's a bit straight. Maybe I want to give the impression instead, right? That it's sort of this... there's a big game trail, right, which is where all the dinosaurs run through, but they would follow particular paths through the game trail naturally, you know, where they dodge rocks and stuff like that. So maybe I want to mix it up a little bit more. Also, can it go through trees? Actually, that's quite important. just going to give it a little... It's really annoying. Once you bend it once, it's very difficult to get it straight again, you know? Yeah, I think that's okay. You're going to see it. I don't know. Oh, I don't know. I either hate it or I love it. I'm very much struggling to decide. Tell you what, let's just build the actual blooming fence and I'll worry about the other stuff first. Later. So, the other thing... There's not really much we can do for this. There's not much to design for the game trail, if we're honest. But... I do want to do this right-hand side ledge bit. Now this, particularly on this sort of higher up bit, a little bit further up, this would be where Owen and Nick and that lot... Nick, that's his name. Not Owen. Why do I keep saying Owen? Chris. No, not Chris. Malcolm. There we go. Malcolm and Hardy. Everyone, they're sort of and Eddie, they're sort of leaning over, looking down at the dinosaurs, right? From like a cliff side. I think it's got an official name. It's like Monument Rock or something. So this is Monument Rock here on the right-hand side. And I want that... bit to stick out a little bit. I think it's a little bit short. It has to be long but thin. Like a worm. Like a wormy penis. Don't know. Sorry, it's been one of those days. Okay, I'm gonna put the other one in as well. I'm gonna get it to kind of try to match it a little bit with that one. I think that's pretty cool. I think it's as close as we're going to get. I'm very, very hopeful that I'll be able to do this kind of thing again in the future, you know, when they add decoration tools and more better terrain tools, maybe with some dirt and stuff like that. It sounds weird that, you know, a dirt tool would be such a big deal, but genuinely speaking, a terrain tool that let me put dirt in would be incredible. I would be all over it. I would be so, so, so excited, which is a little sad, really. But we'll get there. There we go. That's kind of what I'm looking for. So this is where they would lie, look over, and all sad because the dinosaurs are dead and such. Wow. Okay, so... let's grab our fence. We're going to bring this behind. The good thing about this mountain as well is I get to hide the fence behind it, which is really handy. This is big. This is probably going to be the biggest exhibit. There's going to be a lot of dinosaurs and, you know, it's just... I think if you don't make it long enough... I'm probably just going to do it all the way down. Yeah. If you don't make it long enough, then I think it loses the impact of the game trail. You know, it should really feel like a long, thin patch of land. So that is the plan. And we'll have to be a little bit more cautious with the rest of the park because I've just used up half the park. Oh, no, 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 no. I feel silly now. I'm gonna... We can fit something else in there. God knows what, but we can fit something else in there. I'm gonna bring it across there. And then we just need to nip it back down here. Cover it all with trees. Like I said, the game trail is absolutely surrounded by sort of a big clump of forest on both sides. You kind of see them walk into it a little bit when they're dealing with the compy. But, yeah, that's very handy because that's the one thing we can do. Cover things in trees. That's kind of my specialty. So it's going to be a little bit thinner than I maybe would have wanted. That's okay. Meow. It is very satisfying. I'll give him that. It's very satisfying putting down the trees. Game trail. There's some trees dotted about. There's some, I think, about there and another patch maybe over there somewhere. I'm going to put some on the mountain, like on this lower bit of the mountain. I want the rock bit to kind of stick out a little bit more. So if you put trees there and then it's open and this side. Actually, if we could raise this up even higher, that'd be cool. Okay, just about there. And then flatten... something like that, maybe. There we go. That's our. I think that's pretty good. I've got to say, I think it's all right. I'm not convinced on the gyrosphere yet, but we can always get rid of that if need be. I'd really love to hear your opinions on that, basically. Reckon that's our Memenchi finish. Let's kill all this. Now, my one problem is I did want to do the scene with the what do you call it? The trailer. I wanted to do that down in this area here. And I don't think there's any way for us to get here in time. Because I think that's pretty much the next scene we'd be doing. Is that the next scene? Pretty sure it's the next scene. We can always... maybe it doesn't have to be in order. Or maybe you can go around... I don't know. I'll figure something. We'll figure something out. I want this gyrosphere track to go a little bit longer. I do want to start another park. I know, like, usually what we do is we build one park at a time and we just kind of go through it. But I am basically out of ideas for content at the moment. It's hard to keep coming up with stuff to do on this game. So building fun parks is basically the main thing I'm doing whilst we wait for the next patch. And I've seen something on Reddit now. I don't want to just, like, blanket take the idea. I will definitely credit them heavily and stuff like that. But somebody built this awesome park where it's like a lagoon, basically. And so they cover the entire map in water, and then they have, like, individual islands connected by gyrosphere, and that each island is, like, its own little exhibit, and sometimes you'd have, like, a little thin path connected and stuff. The whole thing looks just really, really, really cool, and it's really made me want to do the same thing, so we might start that next week as well. There we go. It kind of looks like a game trail, right? So we need to hide some food in here. Actually, we need to get some water in here as well. Now, there wasn't any water in here in the film, so we can kind of make this up how we want. What I don't want is the dinosaurs to all... What I'm thinking is maybe in the tree line? Because what I don't want is all the dinosaurs to gather up in one spot. I want them to sort of spread around the whole thing, right? So if there's water all the way down... Well, most of the way down... Then that's a bit more instant, and you can't really see it, which is important. It's there, but it's in the trees, which is more understandable. You know, the main bit should feel savanna-esque, and this way the dinosaurs might spread out a little bit more. We also need to hide some feeders. I think maybe just like behind the trees. And again, same idea. I do want these to be spread out a little bit. I'll put three. Nah, there's only one Momenchi. There we go. Right, okay, time to shuffle some dinosaurs over. Should have been doing this for the whole thing. I think what I might do... Actually, let's do it right now. Whilst we're not using this area down here, I'm going to set up a... Oh, am I? Am I, though? Am I? Yes, we're going to set up... yes, okay, just temporarily. We're going to set up another hatchery. I think I should do this every time. We can get rid of this later on. But for now, since we're not building in this area, it's a good idea just to speed up our dinosaur production a little bit. Every single time I've made one of these parks, I have wished that I had an extra hatchery, and I never actually build one. For some reason. Not this time, sonny boy. Boom, boom. Adding task. Lovely. Momenchi, beautiful. Little bit better than the Lost World version. The Lost World version was bizarre in several ways, but it's still very pretty. Gallimimus. So we're going for 6 galleys, and that means I want to change this to something else. Parasaurolophus. Sorry. Will you get out of there, you little nerd? Wait, which one are you? Oops, no, don't make me do things. I can't do things, I'm useless. How many parasaurs do I want? I think there's definitely not many. I'm taking a quick little peek. Okay, I can see one parasaur. Obviously, they wrestle with one parasaur. I can see 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There's loads of them! I'm looking at the image and there's absolutely tons of them. There's more parasaurs than there is galleys, I think. I'm just seeing that image of how they did the parasaur scene. It's very cool. Sorry, I'm just kind of talking to myself whilst I look at images of Jurassic Park. Okay, we're gonna go heavy on the paras and lighter on the Pachycephalosauruses, which are somewhere. Begins with P, best of slot. And this one, this Pachycephalosaurus, is absolutely perfect. It is straight out of the Lost World already. Although it has been genomed for some reason. There we go. I mean, it's you're never going to match the number of dinosaurs precisely with the film, right? It's not really what it's about. That's just me getting my excuses in nice and early. I think we're going to go... I think the good thing about the galleys is, because they're smaller, they kind of just give it a little bit more life, you know? We're going to go for 6 galleys still. I think that's good. But maybe we'll go for like 4 parasaurs. And less Pachycephalosauruses. You really don't see many of them. I only remember seeing one. be wrong. Maybe I'm going to put in two. I just like to have different numbers of dinosaurs, you know? I think it just looks a little bit more interesting, basically. So that's Gallia minus 1, 2, 3, 4. What's up with you? Are you somehow not connected? Doesn't seem likely to me. Oh, you little... Ugh. Right, there we go. So, speed. Speed is of the essence. And we're going to go... This is going to be my parasaur one. Now, what colour do we do for the parasaurs? The default? I think we go default. This has to feel like the film. That's the goal at the end of the day. And we also need a gate over here. And then kill these trees a little bit. I like that idea, actually. So you can't actually see the gate. So you have to drive through and then around the corner a little bit. I like that. Cute. It's less a big deal this time if you can see the gate and stuff. But it's nice to... I think it's nice to have that kind of... You know, little hidden garden feel to it. At least a little bit. Yeah, maybe no one cares. But I care, folks. I care. Where the hell did you come from? Okay, right, so we've got 6 galleys, 2 parasaurs on the way. We're going to go for 6 galleys, 4, we're going to go for 2 pachycephalosauruses. Just because I assume they would hang out together. You know, no one wants to be alone, folks. People might say they want to be alone, and some people probably do, so I don't really have a point. If you want to be alone, that's fine. I have convinced myself I want to be alone, but it's probably not true. Oh, right, okay. I've also taken a little look at what the end of it looks like. And basically, there's a tree line coming out sort of more like there. And then the trail carries on. But it's mainly trees at the end, but it kind of sticks out a little bit. It goes behind the tree line a bit before it disappears into the forest. So that's what I'm trying to do with this little bit sticking out here. And then that would be the rock. Now, no, the rock's here. This is the rock here. Perfect. I think from above, it looks really cool, the... Actually, one thing I want to do, I want to change it to nighttime. It's going to look terrible at night, it really is. Yeah, it's a little... It doesn't quite work as well at nighttime, does it? I think you could do something very cool with this, though. I don't know what it would be, but somewhere out there, there's an idea that makes a very cool usage of this gyrosphere track and these lights. I'd like to be able to walk along that as my park, you know? I think that would look really, really cool to use that as a path. I'm trying to think of a good way to integrate that. The gyrosphere thing, this with the lights and stuff, that looks really nice. No one waiting. It'd be nice to cover it up even more. What I should have done is do a curve at the start, and then you could put trees here. I'm just gonna... it's never gonna happen, so... As long as you get in and you look this way, it's fine. Plus, if we change it back to daytime, it blends in a little bit more anyway. Right then! What are we doing over here? We should get 2 more parasaurs on the go over here. That's our Pachycephalosaurus and 2 more... So many dinosaurs, bloody Nora. Right, this is my 2 parasaurs. Oh, they're ready. Okay. Efficiency, folks. Efficiency. There's our 2nd Pachycephalosaurus. Feel bad for my helicopter pilot, he must be very confused by this point. Shoot this dinosaur, then shoot this dinosaur, then, oh, there's a new dinosaur, shoot that dinosaur. Okay, dokie, transportation has been completed. Momenchi has decided to wander up here for reasons completely unknown to science. What are you doing? Why are you over here? The food and the water is over here for a reason. And so my dinosaurs don't go into this bit, but they're nicely, relatively nicely spread out. All the dinosaurs have landed. It's currently raining, which is fine. We're gonna hop in our jeep and have a little look. Oh, I need my jeeps. I completely forgot to. Didn't I do this last time? Apparently not. Pew pew. Oh, pew. No. Give me a no. There we go. Pew. Right, Ranger Team 3, assemble. Oh, I love that noise. The rain on the windshield makes me so happy. Bomb. We didn't even drive through the Stego exhibit last time, did we? There they are. I kind of want the rain to end. The savannas doesn't really suit it. They really suit it, though. They look great in there. That one in the distance, especially. What are you up to? I'll have a little peek around while we wait for the sun to come back out. Oh, hello. We're all here. Bit moist in it, lads. A little bit moist. Oh, girls, I guess.
Weather conditions normalizing.
I must be getting bloody soaked in there, I tell you. Anyways, onwards. Oh, little peek. Okay. Weather is clearing. Let's head over into our game trail exhibit. Oh, it's a voice! There's a little noise file that plays whenever you open the gate, and I always thought it was like a radio thing, but I think it's like a watch out for the gate or something like that. I still don't know what it actually says, but it's good to know that I wasn't going crazy. Yeah, I'm not convinced by this gyrosphere. As soon as you get close in the Jeep, it kind of looks ridiculous, right? Might have to get rid of that. I think in general, Oh, look at the galleys in the distance. They kind of look like they're herding. That's weird. Dinosaurs don't herd in this game. I think they all just decided they were thirsty at the same time. Hello. I'm going to kill the gyrosphere. I've decided I don't like... Oh, from above I really like it, but as soon as you get down... I just want you guys to tell me. I'm going to let you guys vote. I'm going to do a post, and every comment is going to be a yes or a no, and it's going to be whether I keep the gyrosphere or not. I think from down here it looks stupid, but from above it looks pretty good. And I can't decide if whether that's worth it or not. You are very curious, aren't you? Beautiful. Boop. Well, this is it. Let's drive on a little bit. Where's my Menchi? Let's go find our Menchi. Actually, you know what we should do? We should view it from up here. Ram-da-da-da-da-dum. This is where they would have sat. See, from up here, I think it looks really good. All the dinosaurs have puckered off somewhere. But other than that, maybe I need to keep all my feeders. That's a good point, actually. I'm going to think about that. Yeah, I'm going to get rid of these feeders. And have another one. I want the dinosaurs to be hanging out in that sort of region a little bit more. They should be more here. This is where you want them to be hanging out primarily. Maybe we need more dinosaurs. The thing is, in the game trail scene in the film, the dinosaurs are running away from the Jeeps, right? So they're running alongside the Jeeps, and it seems like there's loads of dinosaurs. And there sort of is a few, but there's not actually that many. But because this place is huge and the dinosaurs are obviously not herding in a straight line across here, because why on earth would they? It seems like there's a lot less dinosaurs than there is in the film, even if that's not actually necessarily the case. I think we could probably, safely though, double up on the number of dinosaurs. So we might load this with a few more before next time. That's beautiful down there though. Doesn't it seem so far away? Now he's trying to become an ostrich. I once suggested that. I've made a joke about hiding your head in the sand like an ostrich. And this guy went on an absolute tirade on me on the YouTube comments. Like, you bloody idiot, ostriches don't do that. Are you an imbecile? I'm like, it was a joke for YouTube, lad. That looks great though. I love the Menchi. Can you come over here though, please? You're in a very stupid position. Where's my tall feeder? Tall feeder is there, right? Water is also over there. You are just being silly. You hear me? Silly. Come here, this way, follow me. I think it actually looks really cool. It's really just long and flat, straight, dinosaurs milling about. I do want to cover the fence area a bit more, I think. So you just have to drive through that little gap there, but you can't really see it so much when you're actually in here. I think we can add more dinosaurs. I've got to say, I think we could add 6 more gallimimuses or so, probably 6 or so more parasaurs, load more packs. I think if we added more, it would account for the difference in style, you know what I mean? But I'm pretty happy with it. I think it's pretty good. So, feel free to answer the many, many questions I've put to you guys over this episode. I'll see you lovely folks next time. If you enjoyed this video, please do smash that like button, because it's ya boy. Oh, God. and I'll see you lovely folks next time. So, the two questions, just to reiterate. Do I keep the gyrosphere? And what do we do next? Wait, I already know what I'm doing next. What do we do? Is my plan good? You know, you've heard the full plan now. Is it a good plan? Let me know. I'll see you folks then. Cheers much love as always.
Bye-bye.
A little shout out at the end. This video and others like it would not be possible at all without the support of you guys watching me at home and also everyone on this Patreon page right here who supported me in the last month. If you want to help out as well, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. Every little really helps. Cheers.